Hello, I'm the Atheist Gamer, and today I'm going to do something a bit different. Just fix the lighting real quick. Much better. You know, I'm just going to do a little bit of a little vlog of some sorts. And, you know, it's mainly about my friend in India, I mean gays in India, and transgenders in India, and a little bit about feminism. I know, I can't just drop it. You know, I can't just leave feminism alone. But don't worry. It's mostly about how, you know, it's basically about my friend Karthik. Like I said before, it's about my friend Karthik. I met him on onlylads.com. I went there because I needed to talk to a few gay people there. I wanted to connect to a few gay people there so, you know, I could make videos that these people, these anti-gay Christians, that have made these anti-gay videos, who feel like homosexuality is some sort of evil, vile, disgusting act. I asked some of the questions towards these gay people, and then, you know, I got the answers. They told me everything, and I thanked them for their help. There's this one particular person, like I said, my friend Karthik. He told me a little bit about his life, and I'll share it with you. He found out that he was gay about, I think, 3 years ago, where before then, he used to be anti-gay. He looked at, he was no different from his friends. He told, you know, he looked down on gay people just like everybody else in India. And just so you know, India is anti-gay. Really anti-gay. You're more likely to die from being gay in India than you're going to die in America for being gay. It's far worse. Anyway. He decided that he couldn't get many girls to like him. So what he did was, he looked at a few, you know, one day he looked at some gay porn, and he thought to himself that it was wrong for him to look at this gay porn, but he couldn't help but watching it. Then 2 or 3 months later, he actually started liking the gay porn and actually started to fall in love. Eventually, his interest in women fades away completely. So now he's completely gay. And he also started cross-dressing about, I think, a year ago. But he has to do it in secret. If anybody found out that he was a cross-dresser and gay, then his family and his friends would treat him like total fucking shit. So now he is currently being a prostitute. That's right, a prostitute in order to raise money. And, you know, he had some unprotected sex here and there. Like, you know, whatever it takes to get out of India and achieve a better life, he has to do it. I know that some of you may be against prostitution, either because, you know, Christian, atheist, Catholic, whatever. If you're against prostitution, you're kind of stupid for opposing prostitution, especially if it's, you know, the only way to get money. He has to do it. He didn't want to do it. He has to do it. It's either prostitution or death. I, you know, I support him doing, I support him being a prostitute because, you know, like I said, I am supportive of homosexuality. I'm also supportive of transgenderality, which I will get to there for a second. In a quick second. So, his friends are still, you know, right now, his friends are no longer bullying him because he spoke out towards one of his friends, one of his best friends, which is a girl. You know, at first he was kind of shocked to find out that, you know, the boy that she likes, I mean, not really likes, that she grew up with is gay. But then she was very accepting, and all her friends, all her female friends, are also very accepting. And one of them even pretended to be his girlfriend, so that way all the boys who thought that Karthik was gay, well, I mean, Karthik is gay, but, you know, they were thinking he was, are off his back, because now he's dating a girl. And, you know, it's wonderful. This is great. You know, people are working together to not only make life a better place for each other, for gays, for women, for everyone. People are finally getting together and realizing that homosexuality is not some sort of evil, vile, disgusting act. This is something that is completely natural. Now, I've also talked to a few transgenders here and there. Not as many as gays, but still a few gays, I mean, transgenders here and there. And, you know, their life, like Karthik, is very difficult because India is full of homophobes and transgender folks. And according to Karthik, transgender folks have it a lot worse than gays. Now, I'm not sure exactly how much, because I see it no different than being gay. The amount of harassment they receive is completely bad. So, right now, my friend Karthik is, you know, raising up money, trying to escape from India, and his friends are backing him up. And he has my support. You know, I really care for Karthik. And, you know, if he gets out of India, that's great. You know, he doesn't have to worry about being hated on for being who he is. He can go to New York. You know, New York is pretty accepting towards gays. He can walk in maybe, you know, in a dress, of course. He can walk in a dress and people will know that he's a man. And people will just wave hi. People will accept Karthik for who he is. It's not a disguise. It's who he is. A cross-dresser. Maybe a woman. I don't know. But for one thing for sure, I'm pretty goddamn sure that New York is more accepting towards homosexuality. I mean, I've seen a few gay bars, for fuck's sake. I've seen, you know, gay pride. I've seen a gay pride parade once. I mean, I wish I was there a bit longer. Meet a few gay people there. Who knows? I could be gay. Could be. But I still like women. So, at the very most, I might be bisexual. But I know that I like women. I still have lots of lesbian porn. And I still masturbate it too. Am I ashamed of that? Of course not. I'm not ashamed to admit to masturbate toward lesbian porn. But I might be bisexual. Because, well, let's face it, women these days, they're becoming total fucking assholes. They're becoming more like the feminists who think that they're so fucking special. And I'll get to that later on. Anyway, once he gets to New York, you know, all his problems would be solved. or at least temporary. But what I really do hope is that India becomes pro-gay. That, you know, more and more people, sooner rather than later, become more open and gay. And more accepting towards gays. That is something that's even better than Karthik having to raise money to escape from a place that should have been pro-gay from the very beginning. But what's making them anti-gay? It's mostly because of religion. And religion pretty much fucks people's minds up. They will tell you things that isn't true at all. It's incredibly dumb that some of these, those who believe in God would go this far to prevent people from being who they are. It's just monstrous. Let's see what else. So, Karthik, if you're listening to this, if you're watching my video, keep up the good work. Keep fighting. Okay? And if you're gay, transgender, lesbian, or genderqueer, or asexual, whatever it, that is not part of the society norms, you have my support. Be who you are. Just don't force who you are towards other people. You know, don't try to change them from who they are to who they're not. Because you don't want to become like the Christians. You don't want to be forcing them to do what the Christians are doing, what the Muslims are doing, whatever religion that people believe in that forces people to change who they are. Don't be like them. Be better than them. Alright? And now, for the final part about feminism. Feminism. The so-called belief in equality. These feminists are nothing more than cunts. Female privilege cunts. They live a life where they're extremely, extremely privileged. And all they want is more. They want more, 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 and more. That's it. They don't really care about women in third world countries. They only care for themselves. And how do I know that? Because we have feminists, like Feminist Frequency. You know, her main focus isn't, you know, real sexism, true, real sexism, harassment, in reality, how women are being abused by their husbands, and, you know, real violence towards women. No, instead of that, we have her complaining about fucking video games. And that's just fucking sad. Pathetic. I mean, here we are, you know, a feminist that could change, you know, could change an entire group of people. And her main focus is the invisible sexism that's inside our video games. This so-called message that video games are sending us to tell that women are inferior beings, that they have no personality whatsoever. I mean, this is incredibly fucking stupid. Feminists shouldn't, you know, the word feminist should be banned from the dictionary. In fact, in 2015, there's a good chance that feminism will be banned. Because feminists are abusing the term feminism in order to make themselves sound like they're some sort of supreme intelligent being. They think to themselves that they are doing something right, when in reality, they are doing something entirely wrong. Just because you believe in equality doesn't mean that you're doing good. Okay, it's the actions that speak louder than the words. And so far, we have feminists pulling the fire alarm of MRA meetings. You know, preventing their group, the group that they're not supposed to be a part of. They're silencing them. We have feminists being completely outraged over vagina cookies. And how the patriarchy, the so-called patriarchy, is oppressing women because they're being paid less than women, being paid less, even though it's been proven time and time again that women do not get paid less, they earn less because of a bunch of freaking factors. They're always going to use the 77 wage gap argument. And it's completely biased. Completely, total, fucking bullshit. Very few feminists have addressed this shit. And those few feminists are not female, but rather male. I mean, are feminists, female feminists, are really this fucking spineless that they couldn't defend themselves, so they had to rely on people such as unseen purity, unworshipity, sequester zone, bewildered ape, what else? Big Lundy? All those people, there are men. These people are men. The only person that I can think of that might have the balls to stand up against me that is a female is Jenny. Jenny Morgan? McMorgancourt? I can't pronounce that. The bitch that I respond to about her video on the Amazing Atheist. And she does a very poor job on impersonating the Amazing Atheist, by the way. You know, she looks more like the brain enema, for fuck's sakes. Let's see. We have these feminists who say that us men, we do not understand what's it like to be female. That because they are female, they're oppressed. That they have no idea on how is it like to be a woman. So they shouldn't talk for male feminists shouldn't, I mean not male feminists, men shouldn't talk for female feminists or feminists in general. And yet these same feminists will speak out for the sake of gays and transgender folks. These people, the gays in India, the transgender folks in India, in fact, not just in India, but in third world countries, they're being oppressed. These people are truly oppressed because they are being oppressed for who they are. I mean, there's nothing hindering, you know, being gay doesn't hinder you from earning less money. It doesn't tell you that you're a piece of shit just because you're gay. You know, and yet these feminists are using gays, transgenders, bisexuals, asexuals as their form of shield. You know what I'm talking about. Not your shield. They're speaking out for them when these people have a voice of their own. These people are nothing more than big fucking hypocrites. Just plain out terrible people. If you're a female feminist, you have no soul. Not in any literal sense, but a metaphorical sense. And if you're a male, feminist, then you do not deserve to have a penis. You deserve to have your balls and penis hang from the wall. Because you just allow women to trample over you like some sort of rug. The only woman that I can say that can still call herself a feminist and have much respect for is none other than Christina Summers. Because at the very least, she actually does her research. She even knows that the wage gap argument is total fucking bullshit. And she's a feminist. A feminist. Talking about a wage gap argument on how it fails. On how biased and completely bullshit the wage gap argument is. I mean, this is a feminist. One feminist. And that is something I thought I would never see today. A feminist debunking the wage gap. That is something that is so incredibly rare. And if more feminists were like Christina Summers, then I would say, yeah, I'd be happy to call myself a feminist. But sadly, this is like an extreme minority within an extreme minority. That, you know, feminists, that these is especially rare feminists. That's only comes once in a fucking lifetime. It's incredible that these feminists are going to use gays, trans, bisexuals, and many other groups of people as their shield. I don't know what else to say. You know, this is probably the main reason why I'm against feminism. Because feminists are turning men into these monsters, these fictional monsters, that they should be ashamed of themselves. That we're the reason why women are being raped. We're the reason why they're being paid less. That our penis basically oppresses women by default. And we should be more like them. Be more like women. Because, let's face the facts. Masculinity is evil. Okay? For a feminist, masculinity is toxic. They're trying to kill masculinity. That's what they're trying to do. They don't care about equality. They just slap the label equality and pretend that they really are fighting for equality, when in reality, they're just shoving dildos up their asses. So, that is all I have to say for now. I am the Atheist Gamer. Peace the game out.